Lee was indeed embarking upon an operation that was one of the most difficult he would face in his military career.
During the sweltering summer of 1863, General Robert E. Lee's Confederate Army of Northern Virginia slammed into General George Gordon Meade's Union Army of the Potomac across the rolling fields, ridges, and hills near Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. Fighting had been savage. Losses had been appalling. Wounded were brought to the division hospitals as quickly as the transportation equipment allowed. Surgeons and assistant surgeons on the battlefield and in ambulance depots provided the necessary triage, while their counterparts at the division hospitals worked feverishly to save critical cases by means of amputation or resection. The retreat from Gettysburg was not only a successful military operation, it indeed restored the balance of power between the two contending armies in the East. Though a tactical defeat, the Battle of Gettysburg was hardly the turning point of the Civil War. It cannot now be argued that it was even the turning point of the war in the East. Instead, the bloody contest would go on for the better part of two more years.